This is Rick Adasco of WeAreChange.org here in Miami, Florida, and there's a lot of breaking, important, developing news right now between the United States and Russia when it comes to their proxy war over Syria. It looks like right now the United States gave up their key geopolitical goal of getting rid of Bashar al-Assad, saying that he could stay. And of course, this is a huge breaking news that has grave implications that you won't hear anywhere else. And we're going to tell you why this happened, how it happened, but most importantly, how you really shouldn't feel optimistic about this kind of pause in the proxy war between these two super world powers. Now, U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry, 5 days ago, traveled to Russia, negotiated with Putin, and said that the United States will no longer seek so-called regime change inside of Syria, and that Bashar al-Assad will stay in power. This is huge because, as we know from the WikiLeaks documents that came out by Julian Assange, that the United States, Israel, and Saudi Arabia have been planning to overthrow Bashar al-Assad since 2006. This is huge. The U.S. invested a lot of money, a lot of key geopolitical moves, a lot of sacrifices all around the world to have this strategic goal. Now, why did the United States want to get rid of Bashar al-Assad? There's many reasons. We covered them before in other videos, and it's too complex to get into now. But let me tell you why this is happening, why the United States gave up their geopolitical goal. On October 28, 2015, 2 months ago, we made a video telling you how Russia will win this war in the Middle East against the United States, because we detailed how Iraq and Jordan have switched alliances and are now joining Russia in the fight against ISIS, abandoning the United States. Why did Jordan and Russia leave the United States with their alliance to fight ISIS? Well, let's look at all the information that has been coming out. According to many sources, American pilots have been silenced over the fact when they were flying missions for over 13 months in Iraq and Syria against ISIS, and they were told specifically not to bomb oil tanker convoys, 4 lanes wide, have been reported secretly, but not reported by the U.S. mainstream media, which is no surprise at all. And as we know, the illegal oil trade that ISIS has been conducting has been financing all of their operations. That's why they have all this money and all this power to do all these horrible things to terrify the Western world like they have been so successfully. People on the ground within our own very military are saying how there's mysterious airdrops of supplies to ISIS and al-Nusra. And this is no surprise. In this video, on this channel before, we covered specifically how the Iraqi military is on the ground showing U.S. military equipment being dropped to ISIS. Then they conquered ISIS and showed the U.S. military equipment that's being airdropped. There's Iraqi commanders saying we had ISIS on the ropes. They were running out of ammunition, and then the United States came in and dropped ammunition to them. The United States was so headstrong with getting rid of Bashar al-Assad, they threw any kind of training, arms, munitions, heavy vehicles they could towards the rebels, and many of them ended up in the hands of ISIS, to the extent that ISIS leaders are even saying that they were funded by the Obama administration. And there's even more breaking news developing right now with hackers hacking 3 ISIS Twitter accounts and tracing them back to the United Kingdom's very own government computers. And of course, Israel, our greatest ally in the Middle East, has not been helpful in any way, shape, or form. They actually just bombed today a Lebanese militant leader in Syria that was fighting against ISIS. And to make the situation worse, just 2 days ago, the United States coalition, their Air Force, took out an entire battalion of Iraqi troops. As Iraqi soldiers closed in on ISIS terrorists on the ground, a U.S. airstrike struck their column, killing approximately 20 Iraqi soldiers and injuring at least 30 more. And we wonder, why is Iraq not joining our global fight against ISIS? This is nothing new. This happened before. And just 2 weeks ago, as we reported to you, the United States also bombed Assad's forces inside of Syria. Assad is saying he will now shoot down any American aircraft because the United States is pretty much bombing anyone who's making any significant gains against ISIS while funding and training them. And if you've been paying attention geopolitically, this is a huge disaster that the United States is only fueling more by its disastrous foreign policy. And that's why John Kerry made those statements. But of course, with all these recent developments, especially with just the bombs dropping today on Iraqi soldiers as they were defeating ISIS, Putin and the Russian government are not naive to this in any way, shape, or form. And that's why Putin gave out a message today saying that he will use any extra forces against the terrorist group. He confirmed his army has not yet even employed all the capabilities inside of Syria to defeat ISIS. He's pretty much saying, we're going to do this on our own if we have to. Putin also praised his security forces today for stopping over 30 planned terrorist attacks and uncovering over 320 foreign spies in his country this year alone. Now, this could be another Red Scare, or this could actually show how real intelligence could actually stop real terrorists. We don't know. Russia and Putin are extremely unpredictable with their political moves, so both scenarios could be true. Putin is also building up his Trump card and improving his nuclear capabilities and weapons as a deterrent and a security factor. He will continue nuclear armament, but he said he will not wield this as a big stick. Now, we know Putin uses nuclear weapons as the major Trump card because he knows without nuclear weapons in a full-out war, the United States and NATO would annihilate the Russian military. The only major Trump card that the Russians have is nuclear weapons. He could see everything that's happening, and that's why he's bolstering up all the nuclear capabilities that he has within his country, which means more of the military-industrial complex, more weapons, more nukes that could utterly destroy this entire planet. The real winners, the military-industrial complex. Not you, not me, not the people of Russia, definitely not the people of Syria, and not all the money that we're spending because the United States is answering back and also bolstering up their nuclear capabilities to utterly destroy everybody. But hey, at least for now, you have alternative media, which is actually winning against the mainstream media. In a new poll, 60% of Americans actually distrust the mainstream media, which shows we're making a significant gain here on YouTube while we could still speak to give you the truth, to give you the news that you can't get anywhere else, geopolitically breaking down what's happening in this world. And not Caitlyn Jenner and all this other, it doesn't matter. What matters is what's happening in the world. Fact check me. All the sources are going to be in the description below, and if you like what you saw, support us on Patreon. I want to thank all the beautiful, amazing people who are giving at least $1 a month and helping sustain real independent media, getting news where you can't get it anywhere else. You want to see us grow? Invest in us, and we will promise to be on the front lines of this information war. Thank you again so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. We're going to have a lot more important details coming your way here on youtube.com/wearechange.